क्लास ट्वेल्थ सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स, ट्वेल्थ चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन। फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी द एडी करंट्स। व्हाट आर द एडी करंट्स एंड हाउ दे आर प्रोड्यूस। सो व्हेन ए सॉलिड कंडक्टिंग प्लेट इज प्लेस्ड इन मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, सो दिस विल रिप्रेजेंट द कंडक्टिंग प्लेट। इट इज सॉलिड कंडक्टिंग प्लेट and it is placed in magnetic field such that this magnetic field will be perpendicular to the plane of the board and directed inwards. Then, due to the relative motion between the conducting plate and the magnetic field, a current is induced in the conducting plate. Now, in this case, the opposing force is developed, so work must be done in moving the conductor with uniform velocity phi. Then the conduction electrons making up the induced current do not follow one path but swings about within the plate as if they were caught in the eddy of water. Such a current is called as the eddy currents. So the currents due to the motion of the conductor will be developed in this conducting plate as if they are caught in the eddy of water, and therefore such current is called as eddy current. So this current will be due to the relative motion between the conducting plate and this magnetic field. That means when this conducting plate is moved through the uniform magnetic field, or if this plate is placed in changing magnetic field, the eddy currents will be produced in that conducting plate, and therefore these are the circulating currents produced in that conducting plate when it is moved through magnetic field or it is kept in changing magnetic field. And hence in the diagram this loop will represent the eddy current loop due to this induced current I, that is eddy current loop, that is a single loop. Then the induced current in the conductor plate is responsible for the transfer of mechanical energy into the heat energy. That means mechanical energy will be converted into heat energy due to this induced current. Then the dissipation of energy as heat energy is more apparent, the dissipation of the energy will take place as heat energy is more apparent. Then after several swings there is no mechanical energy left, and the converted heat energy is dissipated in the plate, making that plate warm. And therefore, when the eddy currents are produced in any conducting plate, it will become warm, and therefore the eddy currents are heat producing currents. Now, let us see the next point, that is self-inductance. What is that self-inductance? For that purpose, let us consider a coil. So this is the coil in which the current is changing. So the current flowing through this coil will continuously change. So this two ends of this coil will be connected to a series combination of rheostat, that is variable resistance, the source of EMF, that is battery B, and a tap key K. So as soon as this key is pressed, it is closed. At that time the current will pass through that circuit or the coil, and that current will increase, then it will reach to its maximum value. Again, when this circuit is broken, that is key is released, at that time the current will go on decreasing and finally it will stop. So like this, there is change in current during the making and breaking of this circuit. And therefore, with the help of this arrangement, the current in that coil will be changed continuously. The changing current vary the magnitude of magnetic flux linked with the coil. So we know that as the current changes, due to that, the magnetic flux linked with that coil will also continuously change. And hence, an EMF will be induced in that coil. So in this coil, as current is changing, the magnetic flux linked with this coil will change, and due to that, an EMF will be induced in that coil. And therefore, the phenomenon of induced EMF in a coil itself, on account of change in current in it, is called as the self-inductance. That is, the current in the same coil will get changed, and therefore an EMF will be induced in that same coil, and hence that phenomenon will give rise to self-inductance. So the phenomenon of induced EMF in a coil itself on account of change in current in the same coil is called as the self-inductance. Now, at any instant of time, the magnetic flux linked with the coil is directly proportional to current flowing through that coil. And therefore, if phi represents magnetic flux linked with the coil and I is the current flowing through it, then we can write phi proportional to I. That is, magnetic flux will be proportional to I, or phi will be equal to Li. Phi is equal to Li, where L will be the constant of proportionality, which is called as the coefficient of self-induction of that coil. It will be also written as L is equal to phi by I, let it equation number 1. So coefficient of self-inductance, L will be equal to phi upon I. Now, here we have considered that coil is having a single turn. Instead of that, if that conducting plate is having n number of turns, if this coil is having n number of turns, then for that coil we can write n phi v. So this will represent the net magnetic flux linked with n number of turns. So n phi b will be proportional to I, or n phi b equal to Li. And from this we can write the coefficient of self-inductance L will be equal to N phi B upon I. Equation number 2. Now, the self-inductance L will depend upon the geometry and material properties of that coil. And now let us see the unit of inductance. What is that unit of self-inductance L that we will have to find? For that purpose, we are having the formulae, and therefore, as per formulae, we will have to proceed in order to obtain the unit of that self-inductance L. And therefore, according to Faraday's law, we know that the induced EMF E will be equal to negative rate of change of magnetic flux linked with that coil, that is, E is equal to minus d phi by dt. And therefore, we can write E equal to minus d by dt of phi is nothing but Li, and therefore minus d by dt of Li we will get, that will be equal to minus L di by dt, because L is constant, and therefore it, out of differentiation it will be taken and only current will be differentiated, and therefore we will get minus L di by dt. And therefore from this we can find unit of coefficient of self-inductance L, that is equal to magnitude of induced EMF E divided by magnitude of di by dt. That will be the formula. Now this E will be measured in terms of volt, di will be measured in terms of ampere, and dt will be measured in terms of second. And therefore, volt upon ampere per second it is called as Henry, and therefore the coefficient of self inductance L will be measured in terms of Henry. Now let us see what is the definition of the self inductance L, that is coefficient of self inductance L, how it will be defined. So it will be now explained with the help of three different cases. So first of all, we will consider as first number, phi is equal to Li. According to that first equation, phi is equal to Li. So this is phi is equal to Li, and therefore phi is equal to Li, or L is equal to phi by I. And therefore, the self-inductance of a coil is the ratio of, it is the ratio of magnetic flux linked with the coil to the current flowing through that coil, that is phi by I. And in general, we can define it as the self-inductance of a coil is the ratio of magnetic flux linked with the coil to the current flowing through it. Now let us consider second point, as L is equal to minus E upon di by dt. So already we have seen that is E is equal to minus dy by dt, and from this L is equal to E upon di by dt in magnitude, and therefore we will consider as L is equal to minus E upon di by dt. By this second point, we can again define the self-inductance of the coil is the ratio of induced EMF produced. So this is the induced EMF produced around the coil to the rate of change of current in that coil, to the rate of change of current in that coil. So self-inductance of the coil is the ratio of induced EMF produced around the coil to the rate of change of current in that coil. Then let us consider third point. So for this third point, we can say that when current increases in the coil, when the current increases in the coil, then the induced EMF acts opposite to it, and hence work will have to be done in order to establish the magnetic flux associated with a steady current I in the coil. And therefore work done in time dt, the work done in time dt will be given as dw equal to ei dt. As electric power is dw upon dt equal to ei, therefore electric work done dw will be equal to ei dt. That will be written as E will be replaced by minus L di by dt into I into dt, since we have written E is equal to minus L di by dt. So in this equation only, this E is replaced, and that will be written as minus Li di by dt into dt. That will be equal to minus Li di, minus Li di, and therefore this will represent small work done. Now the total work done W will be obtained by integrating dW, that is integration dW will be equal to integration from 0 to I0. So the value of current minimum will be equal to 0, maximum will be equal to I0, that is the peak value of current, maximum value of current. So integration from 0 to I0 minus Li di. But now again L is constant, therefore it will be taken out of integration, that is minus L, integration 0 to I0 I di. But integration of I di is I square by 2, and therefore we will get minus L into I square by 2 from 0 to I0. So that will be equal to minus L I0 square by 2, that will be equal to half L I0 square, half L I0 square. And therefore if I0 equal to 1, then W will be equal to L by 2, or L will be equal to 2W from the above equation. And now the self inductance of a coil is numerically equal to twice the work done. So from this last equation, coefficient of self inductance L will be equal to twice of the work done. in establishing the magnetic flux associated with unit current in the coil. Thus, this work done represents kinetic energy. This will represent kinetic energy, and that will be electric kinetic energy will be equal to half L I 0 square, and it will be analogous with the mechanical kinetic energy, that is half M V square. So in this way, electric kinetic energy and mechanical kinetic energy are analogous with each other.